Let's think about right to left on the periodic table. So, you might think it has to do with size, but there's going to be a bigger factor than size when you're going right to left. It has to do with electronegativity. So this factor right here. What element in this picture is the most electronegative? Fluorine. That means it likes to hold minus charge. Is that okay? Whereas, for example, carbon does not. So, can you see how fluorine is more stable than CH3 minus? Because fluorine, because it's electronegative, likes this charge. Carbon does not like that kind of charge. Because of that, which one do you think is the stronger acid? HF or CH4? Yeah, this one here is going to be stronger. So acid strength will go this way now. So it goes to the right and down. It goes to the right because of, I'll just put EN, electronegativity. Okay? So if you're ever comparing two things in the same row, you'll see which one is more to the right or more electronegative. The conjugate base will be more stable because it can hold the charge better. Okay? So here the conjugate base is most stable, so the original acid is stronger. Okay, there's the first two factors. Let's do next inductive effect. Can I erase the periodic table? Okay. So what I'm doing is giving you different factors to look at so that what we're going to do is give you two different molecules, and when you see those two different molecules, you have to say, oh, which one's stronger? And then you go through your list of different factors and see which one applies. So, let's do inductive effect. Let's do... this versus... this factor explains the inductive effect. These two are acids. Which hydrogen do you think is the most acidic hydrogen? I mean, which hydrogen, there's a lot of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which one do you think will most likely fall off? The one on the end. Why is that? That's right. Well, take a look. I'm going to use my eraser a lot here. If I take this one off, I have the minus charge on that. Oxygen. If I take this one off, for example, the minus charge is on the carbon. Which one can hold a minus charge better? What's that?
Oxygen.
Oxygen, why?
Because it's more.
Yeah, that's the electronegative effect. Does that make sense? So way back in Chem 2A, you're like, why y'all is taking it off the hydrogen, off the oxygen? Because the oxygen is more electronegative, and so between these two sets of hydrogens, this hydrogen is going to fall off more readily because of the electronegative effect, what we just learned. Okay? Is that kind of okay? All right, so if that hydrogen falls off because it's the most acidic, we want to figure out which one is more stable. The one with the bromine further away or the one with the bromine closer. What happens in this thing called the inductive effect? If you look at your periodic table, if you have a halogen on your molecule, halogens are very electronegative. Is that okay? So they like minus charges. So what's going to happen is... this bromine likes a minus charge so much that it's going to start to woo that minus charge towards it. Does that make sense? This one too, it's going to woo it toward, like, imagine trying to convince somebody to go to a movie. You're going to woo that person towards going to a movie with you. So it will start to woo it towards itself. Well, can you see that if it's closer, it will do a better job? That's called the inductive effect. So the closer a halogen is, to the minus charge, the more stable this molecule will be because it spreads out that minus charge. Remember, we don't like a minus charge being in one location. We want it spread out or moved around, or just like the I minus, it's a really big fat thing. So this one is actually going to be more stable because there's a halogen closer to the minus charge that will woo that minus charge and spread it out over the molecule. And because the charge is spread out and not localized, or what we call delocalized, this is more stable, so the original acid was stronger. Is that okay? So if I draw you another one, so this is, if I put the H back, this one's stronger. If I draw another molecule, is this going to be stronger than the previous two or weaker?
Stronger
because it's closer to where the minus charge will be. And so it does a better job inductively. Okay? So, strongest. The farther the bromine goes away from the charge, or even if it doesn't exist, the weaker it's going to be. Is that okay? That's the third factor. Fourth one's going to be resonance. Okay, so inductive you haven't seen before, but it is related to electronegativity. Okay, can I erase this? Okay. Inductive you do see a lot in O-chem, though. See, all over the place in O-chem, so you want to get used to that one. Oh, well, I'll tell you so. For inductive, a halogen is good. Good inductive. I'd say maybe second place would be a metal. Like a transition metal, I mean. I'll put TM for transition metal. They're also good. They can do that too. And then bad is organics. Like CH3. So if you had to compare a bromine, Br, versus a CH3, a CH3 is not just, it's the opposite, it's horrible. It makes the charge concentrated in one area. It's the anti-woo. It's like it repels people. You know people on your dorm floor that repel people? That would be like the organic. It's horrible. So this is the exact opposite. Okay, so you're looking for a halogen. Occasionally, sometimes, not very often, but occasionally you see like a metal there. That also will work positively for the inductive effect.